So you have some microgreens that either you grew yourself or you got from the store, but how should you package them? By the end of this video, you're gonna know exactly how to package your microgreens for longer shelf life. And if you stick to the end, I'm gonna show you a special packaging that will make your microgreens last for over a month in the fridge. For the best microgreens content, be sure to subscribe to my channel and ring the bell. That way you get notified when I post a new microgreens video every Tuesday. When I started my microgreens business 3 years ago, I needed to figure out which packaging I was gonna use and what was gonna work best. So I tried a bunch of different sizes and types of materials. And at this point, I've been able to find a packaging that works well for me and that I'm very happy with. I always favor quality over quantity. So my top priority is always making sure that my products are the best around. And packaging plays a big role in that. Not just from a visual perspective, but also from a quality perspective. The packaging that you use will play a role in the shelf life of your product, so I'm happy to show you everything I've learned over the years right now in this video. If you want a high quality product and a long shelf life, your microgreens have to be grown well in the first place. If your microgreens aren't healthy, they're not gonna last long after you pack them. Assuming you're packing quality greens, there's some other factors to consider. The microgreens shouldn't be wet when you're packaging them. Wet product will rot quicker, so make sure to master your watering schedule. That way, when you go to harvest your greens, you aren't working with wet product. You also want to be as gentle as possible when harvesting. Keep in mind that microgreens are simply very young plants, so they're very fragile. If you're too rough with them, you're going to bruise the plants, which will cause them to die and rot almost instantly. Comment below and let me know if you've ever been disappointed in the shelf life of produce that you've bought before. And if you have any special tips or tricks for making your greens last longer, also let us know in the comments below. Once I've confirmed that the handful of microgreens I just harvested is nice and clean, I'm just gonna put them right into the container and slap a lid on it, and that's it. Another important factor is the storage temperature. I keep my fridge in here literally as low as possible, right at 33. I find this makes my greens last really well. Just be careful not to freeze them by accident, because if you freeze the greens and don't intend on keeping them frozen, they're gonna die right away. As far as packaging goes, what's most important is putting the right amount of product into the container. Not too much and not too little. You don't want a ton of air in the packaging because that's gonna contribute to the oxidation of your plants. This being said, you also don't wanna stuff your microgreens into the package because one, this can damage your product as you're doing that. And two, I find that the microgreens like at least a little bit of space to breathe. Also, if there's any excess moisture in with the greens and they're packed too tight, they're gonna start to rot. If I'm packaging smaller quantities of plants, I use plastic clamshells, but the bags that I use for packaging larger quantities will literally make bigger varieties like pea and sunflower last for over a month in the fridge without a problem. The bags are called Keep It Fresh Produce Bags, and I buy them right on Amazon. I'll put a link below so you can see the exact bags that I'm using, and I'll also drop two links for the other packaging that I'm using, the smaller clamshells and then the bigger clamshells, which I get from webstrontstore.com. So now you know how to package your microgreens so that they last longer, but what if you want some inspiration on how to eat your microgreens? Use the link below in my description to join my microgreen support group on Facebook, where we share recipe ideas. This way you can get a better idea of how to use them in your own cooking, or you can send this information to your customers to help them use your products as well. Check out these videos if you want to see exactly how I grow my microgreens or how to see how I harvest my microgreens with a knife. If you like this video, be sure to like it below, subscribe to my channel, and share it with your friends. Thanks so much.